Robinson. Many consider him. We welcome you to the. These athletes have been waiting a long time to square off. Here we go. Oh, and they just got their bell rung.
He blocks the hook.
Can he seal the deal here in round one? Incredible start to this fight. Looks like they're out of trouble. This is such an amazing theater. So many great concerts have been performed here, but nothing quite like what we're going to see here.
But I love theaters for all these reasons. You can hear everybody in the crowd. You can hear the punches out. Echoing. You're a fighter coming in, and you know you're in such an intense atmosphere. You know the pressure is going to be on.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
He's locked that jab. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. This fight could not be any closer, put it, Johnny.
It's too hard to split. Do you listen to your head or your heart?
Here we go. It's round two. Through the hooks, didn't land. A counterfighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
Counterpunch is my favorite kind of fighter. A good counterpunch is the people that make the history of our sport.
To finish the show right now. Can he find that one big shot? It appears the onslaught is over, at least for now.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
He fails to score with that left hook. Gets out of the way of that left hand. This counterpuncher is going to wait for you to move first, and then will strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy.
Reaction is second to none. It's the blink of an eye, and they're waiting for end.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. About you, Johnny, but I'm getting a little bit sleepy.
Come on, give him a break.
And there's the bell for round three. jab well at all. Got out of the way of that right hook. Blocks the jab. Let's see as these two fighters start to feel each other out. One will probably rely more on their speed than their power.
This is why I love the little guys. This is exactly why I love them. Look at them, toe to toe, heart for heart. Romano, Romano, they're letting the shots go.
Can they figure out the combination to this safe? Absorb that hook. And misses with that jab. That big hook doesn't land. Fighters certainly not going to outthrow their. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. This one could go either way. Every round is so important.
That was super tight. I dread being a judge.
Who's going to be the first one to get caught? Right hook just missed. Fantastic punch. A power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, thinking, you just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little fag of a pickpocket.
Missing with that right hook. And they figure out the combination to this sink. It is official now, and that is not the way anyone wanted this fight to end.
No complaints there at all. The crowd agree, I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
What a night we expect it to be. We are live at the CompuBox Academy. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
You tried to give me the slip, didn't you, my friend? There was no way.
Sugar Ray.
Just bowed it.
What a pleasure to be in this unique. We waited a long time, and now we've got this fight. Right punch. Hook hurt him. And he fails to score with that left hook. What a pleasure to be in this unique environment. Every seat has been taken for tonight's match.
So hot, so heat, there's a roof on here, you don't understand it. When you're working, when the noise is there, the pressure's on, you're thirsty, you're sweating, and you're getting under, you're on the wrong side of a beating. This can be a hellfire on here.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Both men step back for just a moment. Disaster averted, it seems. We continue on. He misses with that jab. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Robinson got buzzed there. He's in trouble. Much to write home about in that round, huh, Johnny?
No, not.
There's the bell for round two. He didn't take that jab well at all. Counterpuncher is going to wait for you to move first, and then we'll strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy.
Counterpuncher is my favorite kind of fighter. A good counterpuncher, they're the people that make the history of our sport.
This counterfighter believes in the anything you can do, I can do better. They'll let you throw a punch first, and they'll answer you and usually hit you harder. Changes from both men in this round. Oh, and there he caught him with a stiff jab. A counterfighter relies a lot on their instincts and reaction time. You've got to get in there quick to punch your opponent before he gets his fist back to block.
They have got great ring IQ. Counterpunches are the best.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. This fight is closer than two pages in a book, Johnny.
So important. The referee's got to do his fight right. He's got to judge this right. He's got to do his job right.
Who's going to be the first one to get rocked? He
like to see more jabs.
Unlike the heavier fighters, these fighters throw so many punches, it's hard to keep up.
Oh my goodness, that little Yorkshire Terriers, they're never going to give up.
He takes that jab.
Sugar Ray Robinson just got rocked. He's got him right where he wants him. Now what? Can he close the show? Looks like they've shaken it off. Someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses, how do you deal with it?
When you have a fighter that's got that great footwork and that great hand speed, it's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Can he finish the job?
It's now or never for the club. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Can he finish this here?
Could not have come soon enough for this guy.
Every second, every minute of this fight.
Here we go in round four. Who's going to land the first big shot? He threw the hook, didn't land. Jab. Oh, and he caught him with a left hook. The old adage is, no matter how much speed you've got, timing beats speed.
Some fighters are just gifted. Gifted with such hand speed, footwork, movement. They are gifted. They are the chosen few.
Back and forth they go. Neither fighter willing to back down. When are we going to see a jab from these two? Boxing movies, the training scenes, the gym work. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated...
A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Which fighter is winning this bout?
It's too hard to split. Do you listen to your head or your heart?
Each one of these athletes is going to be the first to go down. Just missed. clean jam. Have given out a little bit. He's got to start firing back. This guy certainly has a huge chin. How are they still standing? You're a power puncher. You're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you got to think them. You've just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little fake of a pickpocket them.
Can they figure out the combination to this safe? That hook was thrown with some bad intentions. Let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. You hear people talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. Who's winning this fight right now? I have no idea.
That was super tight. I dread being...
Here's the bell to start round six. Missing with the left hook. Parries that right jab away. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
Big shots from both these fighters. Got to be careful, though. With the hook. He misses with that jab. Swing and a miss with that left hook. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. I don't know which fighter is winning this battle.
It's too hard to split. Do you listen to your head or your heart?
Which fighter's going to get clipped first? Second win. You've got to find it somehow.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
To the body, trying to wear him down. In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power, and I think this boxer has decided I can walk through anything that lands.
Don't get trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be guessing yourself out trying to get that shot, and that's when they catch you.
These two are the perfect dance partner.
Good right hand.
I don't believe it. One of the all-time greats, Robinson, goes down. Like he's going to survive the round here, but just barely. Well, he is in big trouble here. And there's the bell to start round eight. Jab just got blocked.
And he caught him there with a left hook.
How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
Hit him with a left jab. Nice hook. Robinson got buzzed there. He's in trouble. A true champion knows how to get out of trouble after they got into trouble, and that's what he's doing here. How much confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through?
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like a crisp. As soon as you touch them, they're gone. And this
round could go either way, 10 seconds to go. Could not be any closer, could it, Johnny?
So important. The referee's got to do his fight right. He's got to judge us right. He's got to do his job right.
There's the bell to start round nine. He missed with that jab. Nice exchange here from both men. Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Having second thoughts in the ring.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Neither man really defending themselves. And he caught him with a left hook. Right jab. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. This fight is closer than two pages in a book, Johnny.
That was super tight. I dread being the judge.
This fighter's gonna get clipped first. And he misses with that jab. A big whiff with the right hook. That left hook missed. No doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
You've got to be courageous when you're getting in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain, man.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Trying to land the left hook, but was not successful. Just misses with that jab. And he just missed with that left jab. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. This one could go either way. Every round is so important.
It's too hard.
He will be buzzed first. Endurance is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
Now you've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. What gets you through? Willpower. Calm, because if you panic, you get desperate. If you get desperate, you make mistakes. If you make mistakes, you get knocked out.
The jab, but it doesn't score. Can they figure out the combination to this save? There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for those pointed areas over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them, skim and go for speed.
That jab not going to score. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. This fight is closer than two pages in a book, Johnny.
That was super tight. I dread being a judge.
Which which one of these athletes is going to be the first to get rocked. Oh, that punch. How do they use this fighter's aggression against them?
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get you there. They want you to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tell. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them as they set their shots. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't work.
Clean left jab. Figure out the combination to this sink. That jab misses. You've seen all the famous boxing movies, the training scenes, the gym work. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system to a certain amount of punches per round, because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again and the fight will be over.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. And that's it. A unanimous decision win.
Unanimous. You know what? Smart, that is. A total change of styles to make sure they got it. Had every round in the bag. There was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.